So in this section, we are going to discuss about the calculation of Euler's phi function if the given number is what? If the given number is a composite number. So the first thing we will write, the first result that we will write is that if p is a prime number, then the phi of p raised to k is given by the formula p raised to k minus p raised to k minus 1. This is the first formula that we will use to find the Euler's phi function for a number p raised to k. The second formula that I will use is that if n is equal to p1 raised to r1 into p2 raised to r2 and up to pk raised to rk. So this factorization is called as the canonical factorization of the given number. Okay. Then phi of n is equal to phi of p1 raised to r1. I'm just replacing n by what? Replacing n by p1 raised to r1, p2 raised to r2, up to pk raised to rk. This is equal to, I will separate out this phi to every person which is in the canonical factorization. So I will write it as phi of p1 raised to r1 into phi of p2 raised to r2 into up to phi of pk raised to rk. Okay, so these two formulas that I have mentioned just now, we will use these two formulas and find the value of phi for composite numbers. So let me give you one simple example. What is phi of 25? You will calculate the value of phi of 25. So solution, what is the canonical factorization of 25? Whenever I get a number which is composite number, I will use the canonical factor. If the number is a prime number, then we know that if the number is prime, then what is phi of p? Phi of p comes out to be p minus 1. So we will not look at prime numbers right now. We are only looking at composite numbers. So what is the canonical factorization of 25? The canonical factorization of 25 is nothing but 5 square, 5 into 5. So what is phi of 25? Phi of 25 is equal to phi of 5 square, right? Because this 5 is a prime number, so it's a canonical factorization. In canonical factorization, you need prime numbers at the base. The powers can be anything, right? So your power is 2. So what is phi of 5 square? We want to find it. Now, the first formula tells us that by formula 1, I know that phi of p raised to k is equal to how much? Phi of p raised to k is p raised to k minus p raised to k minus 1. So what will I write here now? It is 5 raised to 2 minus 5 raised to 1 power less. So it is 5 raised to 2 and this is 5 raised to 1. So this will be how much? This will be 25 minus 5. And phi of 25 is how much? Phi of 25 will come out to be 20. Similarly, if I do another example and if I want to find what is phi of 49, now again, I know that 49 can be written as what? 49 is actually 7 square. This is the canonical factorization of 49. And therefore, what is phi of 49 equal to? Phi of 49 means phi of 7 square. And what is phi of 7 square? The formula tells that it is p phi of p raised to k is equal to p raised to k minus p raised to k minus 1, 1 power less. So it will be 7 square minus 7 raised to 1. And this will be 49 minus how much? 49 minus 7 will be 42. Okay. Simple example. What is phi of 8? Phi of 8 is equal to how much? Now phi 8 can be written as, the canonical factorization of 8 is 2 into 2 into 2, right? So means phi of 8 is how much? Phi of 8 is equal to pi of 2 cube. What is pi of 2 cube? Pi of p raised to k. The answer is p raised to k minus p raised to k minus 1. So it is 2 cube minus 2 raised to 2, one power less, which is 8 minus 4. And therefore, the answer will come up to be how much? Pi of 8 is equal to 4. So now we will find the value of the Euler's function if the number is a composite number. And we will first write the canonical factorization of that number. So I will write the question, find phi of 100. So solution, I will first write the factorization of 100 until I get the factorization to be a canonical factorization. You can use any factorization you want. Suppose I write 100 is 25 into 4. And then this I can write it as 5 into 5 into 2 into 2. So now no further factorization of 100 is possible because 5 and 2 are both prime numbers. So we will write this is 5 square multiplied by 2 square. So this is a canonical factorization of 100. Now we will write phi of 100. What is phi of 100? Means it is phi of, replace 100 by that number, which is phi of pi square. I will write it below so that there will be no confusion, which is equal to phi of 100 is going to be replaced by what? 5 square multiplied by 2 square. I will separate out this phi to 5 square and 2 square because these two primes are distinct primes. They are not the same prime. 5 is a distinct prime, 2 is a different distinct prime. Okay, so which is equal to what? Phi of 5 square multiplied by phi of 2 square. This is the second formula that we have written above. Okay, now what is phi of 5 square? So whatever this answer is, multiplication is going to be. What is phi of 5 square? Now this, for this I will use the first formula, that phi of p raised to k is how much? P raised to k minus p raised to k minus 1. So in bracket, I will write here. Phi square. Minus 5 raised to 1. Multiplied by what is phi of 2 square? Again, it is power of prime. So I will write 2 square minus 2 raised to 1. So this is nothing but 25 minus 5 multiplied by 4 minus 2, which is 20 multiplied by 2. And therefore this will be how much? This will be 40. So what is the answer? So phi of 100 is equal to how much? Phi of 100 is equal to 40. What is the meaning of this? What is the meaning of phi of 100 equal to 40? Means if I take the numbers from 1 to 99, if I look at all the numbers from 1 to 9, how many numbers will be relatively prime with 100? Okay, I'm not counting the numbers which are prime numbers between 1 to 100. We are not counting the prime numbers between 1 to 100. What are we counting? We are counting all those numbers which are relatively prime with 100. Means that number and 100 do not have any common divisor except one. So if I want to list those 40 numbers, which are those numbers which are relatively prime with 100? The first number I will write is that 1 is relatively prime with 100 because GCD of 1 and 100 is 1. I cannot write 2 because the GCD of 2 and 100 is how much? The GCD of 2 and 100 is 2. So 2 will be out of this list. The next number will be 3. 3 is also relatively prime with 100 because there is no common divisor. 4 and 100 are not relatively prime. Which is the common divisor between 4 and 100? The common divisor between 4 and 100 is 2. So the GCD is 2. GCD is not 1. Relatively prime means the GCD has to be 1. So the next number is 5. 5 and 100 are also not relatively prime. 6 and 100 are also not relatively prime because 6 and 100 have a common factor 2. 7 and 100 are relatively prime. So 7 will be the next candidate in this list. And I will continue writing who is the last number which is relatively prime with 100. If I look at 98, 98 and 100 are both these numbers have GCD 2 because 2 is a common divisor between them, right? So 98 and 100 are not relatively prime, but 99 and 100 are what? 99 and 100 are relatively prime. So how many such people we will get? We will get such 40 candidates will be in that list, which are what? Which are relatively prime with 100. Let me do one more problem now. Suppose I want to calculate the value of phi of 300. This means that I will first write the canonical factorization of 300. I will start with whatever simple factorization I know. I can simply say that 3 into 100 is 300. 100 can be further factorized as what? 100 can be further factorized as seen above. 100 can be written as pi square multiplied by 2 square. So this is the canonical factorization of 300. Now I will take phi of 300. So phi of 300 is equal to, in the next step, I will write equal to phi of 3 multiplied by 5 square multiplied by 2 square. Then by the next formula, by the second formula, this phi can be given to each member once you have reached the canonical factorization is equal to phi of 3 multiplied by phi of 5 square multiplied by phi of 2 square, which is equal to phi of 3. You know that 3 is a prime number. So if you have a prime number, what is phi of p? We all know that phi of p is equal to p minus 1. So what is phi of 3? Phi of 3 will be 3 minus 1. What is multiplied by? What is phi of 5 square? Now I'm going to use the second formula, phi of p raised to k, which is 5 square minus 5 raised to 1. Multiplied by phi of 2 square is 2 square minus 2 raised to 1, which is further equal to 3 minus 1 is 2, multiplied by 20, because 5 square minus 5 is 20, multiplied by 2 square minus 2 is 4 is 2. So I will have how much? 20 into 4 will be 80. So this means that phi of 300 is equal to 80.